One of the biggest topics in Algebra 1 is factoring. There are many, many ways to factor polynomials, and it's a skill that you'll use in nearly every future math course you take, which makes factoring one of the must-know skills. Today's tutorial is the first in a series that I'm doing on factoring polynomials. So do yourself a favor and click that subscribe button right now so that you don't miss out on this series. Today's lesson, we're going to be covering the reverse of the distributive property, which is how to factor out the greatest common factor. Let's get started. In this first problem, we want to factor out the greatest common factor of 4x and 12x squared. Now to begin, I'm going to write out these two factors longhand. And this is a step that you'll likely skip in your mathematics. In fact, after this first problem, we will skip it as well. But I just want to start with making it very obvious exactly what's going on. So I'm going to split 12x squared into 3 times 4 times x times x. Now I can see that there is a 4x in both of these terms. So the 4x is what I'm going to pull out in front. What's left behind, I will place in parentheses. And a common mistake here would be to pull out the 4x and not leave something behind. It is extremely important that if you factor out an entire term, you write a placeholder 1 in its place. This ensures that when I multiply the 4x back through, I do get the 4x term that I started with. And here we'll have 3x left behind from the second term. So our final answer for this first one is 4x times 1 plus 3x. And if you wanted to check your answer, which I would recommend when you're first beginning, you simply need to distribute the 4x back through and make sure that you get the original expression. Since when we distributed the 4x back through, we got 4x plus 12x squared, I have ensured that I have correctly factored out the greatest common factor. In the second problem, we want to factor out the GCF of 10x to the fifth plus 4x cubed. Now, an alternate way to do this, if you don't like writing out the expanded form, is to divide. So I want to think about what is common to the coefficients and what is common to the variables. On first glance, I see that both 10 and 4 are divisible by 2. So I want to divide out a 2 from both. I also see that this first term has 5x's being multiplied together, and this second term has 3x's being multiplied together. So I have at least an x cubed I can divide out of both of these terms. This means that 2x cubed is the greatest common factor that we are going to factor out. And the answer to the divisions I have here will be what is left behind to go inside of our parentheses. So 10 divided by 2 is 5. X to the fifth divided by x cubed gives me x squared. 4 divided by 2 is 2. And x cubed divided by x cubed is 1. So I don't need to write anything for those, and I get 2x cubed times 5x squared plus 2. Similarly to how we checked the first problem, we could go ahead and multiply 2x cubed through both of these terms to ensure that we get 10x to the fifth plus 4x cubed back out. The same technique holds no matter how many terms we have in our expression. We just need to make sure that each of those terms is divisible by the same values. So I'm going to begin by looking at the coefficients. I have 15, 10, and 5. So I see that all three of these are divisible by 5. So that is the first thing I'm going to divide out. Next, I see that each of these terms has a b, so I can pull out a b as well. Notice that I can't pull out an a though, because only the first two terms have a's and the third term doesn't. So you need to make sure that whatever you're pulling out is common to all of the terms in your equation. Here we have 5b as the greatest common factor, so I'm going to write that in front. And in parentheses, I'm going to write the resulting division. So here I have 15 divided by 5 is 3. AB squared divided by B leaves me with just AB, since this B cancels with one of these. On our second term, we have 10 divided by 5, which is 2. A squared B divided by B, the B's cancel out, and I'm left with A squared. And in this final term, we get 5b divided by 5b, which equals 1. Notice here that the nice thing about using the division method is that it ensures that you get a 1 placeholder left behind, whereas when we just pulled it out in this first problem, we could easily miss writing it in our answer. Here I have a slightly trickier problem. For the most part, it just looks really hard, but actually it's pretty straightforward. So what I have is 2x squared times the quantity x minus 1 minus 8 times the quantity x minus 1. So here you see that I have an x minus 1 in both of these terms. So x minus 1 is going to be pulled out or divided out. Furthermore, I have even coefficients on both of these, so I could divide both of these by 2. That means that my greatest common factor and the factor I'm going to be dividing by is 2 times x minus 1. So to get started here, I'm going to write 2 times x minus 1. And then in a parenthesis, I am going to write the remaining terms that I get after dividing. So in the first term, I have 2 divided by 2, which cancels out to 1. The x minus 1s also cancel out, and so I'm simply left with x squared. In this second equation, the x minus 1s again cancel out, and 8 divided by 2 is 4, so I have minus 4. Now, this problem has a special little bonus problem in it because we get x squared minus 4, which is a difference of perfect squares. And I know we haven't talked about this yet, but this is a great opportunity to introduce it. This can be factored into x plus 2 and x minus 2. So for our answer, we get 2 times the quantity x minus 1 times the quantity x plus 2 times the quantity x minus 2. Again, this factoring of perfect squares is something we haven't talked about, but I will be talking about it in an upcoming video, so keep an eye out for that if it's new to you. For the final problem, we are factoring out the GCF of 4x cubed y minus 5x squared y squared minus x squared y plus 8xyz. Now, this problem looks a lot more difficult than it is, just because it has a lot of terms and a lot of variables. You want to approach it just like any of our previous problems, first looking for anything the coefficients can divide by. Here we have 4, 5, 1, and 8 as our coefficients, so there's nothing we can divide out there. Next, let's look for x's. Here I have x cubed, x squared, x squared, x. So it looks like that between these four terms, I have at least one x. So I am going to divide out an x. Next, let's look at the y's. I have y, y squared, y, and y. So I can also pull out a y. And And lastly, on this term, I have a z, but none of these other terms have z's, so I can't pull that out. This means that my greatest common factor is x times y. So I'm going to start by writing that down. And then whatever I divide is going to go inside parentheses. So here I have 4x cubed y divided by xy. I can cancel out one of the x's with one from the numerator, leaving x squared, and the y's cancel out. So here I have 4x squared. In our next term, we have again an x that can cancel out and a y that can cancel out. So I'm left behind with negative 5xy. Next, I can cancel out an x and the y's. This gives me minus x. And lastly here, the x and y cancel out, leaving me positive 8z. There you go, that's our final answer. On the next episode of Math Hacks, I am going to show you how to factor a quadratic trinomial into two separate binomials. And it's just like the most important factoring problem you'll ever run into. So you're gonna wanna keep an eye out for it. Till next time, I'm Brett, and thank you so much for joining me.